Anybody that plays Betty Jeopardy? Woo-hoo-hoo! Yeah! All right. So I'm Hopeful Cannon. I'm the organizer of the event. And this is our fifth annual Gnome Academy Bench Fest! Woo! Yay! So excited, so excited. All right, I hope you're having fun. I hope you're eating lots of good food. And I hope you're enjoying the day. Okay, we're going to get right into it. I am going to introduce our awesome host for the Veggie Jeopardy game, and that is Mike the Vegan. Woo! Mike's a vegan science YouTuber that covers a variety of topics from health effects of the vegan diet and from the environmental impact of eating animal products to the sociological phenomenon of animal exploitation. I got through it. All right. Mike regularly tackles debunking the myths that perpetuate harmful dietary and lifestyle behaviors. And today, he will be hosting Sonoma County Veg Fest's first ever Veggie Jeopardy game. So, please welcome our celebrity YouTuber, Mike the Vegan.
All right, thank you so much for coming. We have three teams of two that we're going to do. We want one more person, one genius of plant-based magic from the audience to join Andy, our super tall dude, Red Bear. So who feels like they know stuff? You feel like they I think he raised his hand first out there. Yeah, the one in the middle back there. Yeah, he was up first. But yeah, thank you everybody for being willing to go up in front of the crowd and look stupid. No, seriously, no judgment here at all. There's no wrong answers. You can shout. They can shout the wrong answers. And it's really fun. So feel free to step up right now. We got each team has a buzzer, which is cool. So we are going to choose some teams. So teams of two, choose what fruit you want to represent you in the Vegan Jeopardy game. Watermelon. Okay, so we got watermelon over here. What do you think? Watermelon, onion, and banana. You have to choose banana. Come on. Okay, watermelon, onion, and banana. All right, and this time I actually have somebody doing it for me over there. So round of applause for Mr. Doing It over there. Yeah. All right, sweet. So let's do this. Do you get it going? Okay, start the game. Okay, which team is going to go first? Okay, you're going first. He works for the animal sanctuary, so he gets to go first in everything. Yeah. Okay, so can you guys see everything very well? Okay, so here are our categories. We have plants, animals, the environment, where do you get your protein, veggie celebs, and mad vegan scientist. And so you can choose. You can choose whichever one you want. Of course, as normal Jeopardy goes, it's categories from each category is $1 to $500. And so go for it. Choose which one do you want. Wouldn't get your protein for $300. Okay, what are we looking at? The official name for a protein deficiency. This one is actually quite hard. This is hard. It's like the only one that people don't get, so. Do you get it? Does anyone in the audience know? They know. They know right there. Are we sure nobody knows? Oh, wow. Do you want to guess? No? Okay, well, let's just get an audience one, yeah? Kwashi Orkor is the answer, so skip the answer on the top right. You got it, yeah. Kwashi Orkor, why have you not heard of it? Why do they not know it? Because it's so rare. There's no protein deficiency award in the hospital. And so that's why you don't know Kwashi Orkor. Thankfully, we're blessed for not knowing it. All right, so let's just go ahead and move down the line. You guys want to go? Team Onion is going to go next. So choose whatever you want. Pay for $200. All right, a review of studies on the topic found that this plant may burn steel 8 days quicker. Pretty cool. Oh, and by the way, audience, keep an eye on who's picking the buzzer first, because I can't. Was it you? Okay, what was it? Aloe vera is the correct answer. Good job. Yes, amazing. The study looked at a bunch of other studies where they had people with burns, and they applied aloe vera to the skin, and they found that it made it heal 8 days quicker, as the question says, which is amazing. The magical power of plants. Okay, so the winner gets to guess the next category. Choose the next category. That was Team Banana. Team Banana for the money. Great. Okay, now what do you want to do next? We've got, continue onward. And, okay. Plants for $300. Okay. We have antioxidants from plants increase this color tone in your skin, an increase which several studies found to be more attractive.
Close, but anyway, any other guesses?
No.
There's only so many colors in the rainbow, so did you ever guess at it first?
No.
You gotta hit a buzzer and say the answer.
Yellow is the correct answer. Yellow is what makes you hot,
apparently, according to one study. So that was, once again, Team Banana.
Yeah, and it's interesting because that's from carotenoids in the vegetables that you eat. And it also happens in your eyes, which is cool. So people hear, oh, I went raw and I ate all these different plants, and all of a sudden my eyes started changing, they went green or whatever. It's because it's kind of a ring of yellowness that builds up around your pupil, which is carotenoids building up. So that is actually pretty awesome. Again, the amazing power of plants. All right, let's see. We got to get together.
Cleaning up plants for $500.
All right, legumes make protein by absorbing this element from the air.
This element? Wow.
Nitrogen is correct, yes. They fixed nitrogen, that was Team Watermelon. Team Watermelon with the money, boom, $500. And they do it via nitrogen fixation, which is a cool.
Well, we're playing really bootleg Jeopardy right now.
Oh, this is the first of many rules which will be broken. So if you have OCD about Jeopardy, then you might as well step out.
All right, but yeah, thank you. I appreciate it.
Because I will probably get something wrong, so feel free to just shout at me. No problem at all.
Okay, so you get to guess the next answer, Team Watermelon.
Mad Vegan Scientist for $100.
In the very top, tippity top of your head.
Okay, the question is, this religious population in Loma Linda, California, is the base of many vegan health studies. The Seventh-day Adventist Onion, Team Onion, won that one. Yes,
that's decently close.
Yeah. There you go. Round of applause.
So you get to choose the next question.
Mad Vegan Diet Scientist for $200, moving right up the ladder. And the question is, in a study, the blood of subjects on a plant-based diet was 7 times more effective at slowing the growth of blank.
Cancer, correct, yes.
Yes, they literally took cancer, put it in a petri dish, took people, normal people, and then people on a plant-based diet, dripped their blood on it, and this was able to slow the growth.
Breast cancer.
So that goes to Team Onion, right?
Yeah, Team Onion.
Specifically, breast cancer was what that study was on. We also have ones showing that it can kill cancer more effectively, which is pretty amazing. So that was one of the studies that actually got me changing my diet. So, okay. Next question.
Magic scientist for 300.
Okay, moving right on. This doctor's trial showed rapid reversal of artery clogging in 3 weeks on a whole food vegan diet.
Yeah.
Yes, Dr. Esselstyn is correct. Watermelon for the win.
A way to reverse cardiovascular disease in the middle of the study is free. You can just look at it. It's pretty cool. You got all the angiograms cleared out before and after. So go ahead and get another one. Go for it.
Magic Assassin 400. We're just wiping that whole column out. All right. Athletes can increase your cardio performance with plants containing this compound.
Can you do it?
Yeah.
I'll give you a hint if you can't get it.
Yeah?
You guys want to hint?
Do you want to guess?
You're allowed to guess.
Your hand's on the trigger. Yeah.
Yeah, no?
Yeah, hold it up.
It's related to an earlier question, the earlier section.
Yeah, that's correct. Nitric oxide or nitrate? Nitrate is the official, yeah. You got it. That is Team Banana. Killing it over there with $900, and so it's also just called beet doping, because beets have a lot of nitrates, and athletes can increase their performance with that, and so they call it beet doping. Obviously, it's not real doping, but yeah.
You beet dope?
Your shirt says beet to me on it.
So,
and it has a picture of a beet, so perfect for watching that go.
Okay, next.
Yeah, oh, yeah, you go, sir. Animals for 100. And the question is, Benjamin Franklin wanted this animal to be the national bird instead of the bald eagle.
What is the turkey?
Correct.
The turkey
is, bald eagles are sort of vicious and warring, and so they're like, why don't we play more chill out like a turkey? And they're like, no, we want to be vicious and warring. So that didn't happen. Okay, that's the next one.
Watermelon. Oh, yeah, sir. Yeah, that's Team Watermelon. All right, so what do you want next? Let us know. Okay. Animals for 200 bucks. What is the most consumed animal in the world? Was the question. Jump the gun. Chicken is, yes, they consume 50 billion chickens in the every year, which is insane. Yep, that's Team Ben. Cleaning up 50 billion. In fact, I actually read recently it's closer to 60, but you know, not a lot of different sources. So, that's the next one. Environment for $100. Which sparks more methane, grass-fed or grain-fed cows? Grass-fed does. Wow, you guys are too good. There you go. And, yep, that's the name of the study. In case you want to look at it, it's about 3 times more methane. If you take a cow and you feed them some just straight-up grain, and then you take another cow and you feed them straight-up grass, they will actually fart more methane with gas. It's harder to digest. And so when people say grass-fed is super eco, everyone needs to be grass-fed, it's still not eco. It's still spewing a bunch of methane, which is, you know, 80 times more potent, potentially, as carbon in the atmosphere. So, next up. Environment for 200, and the question is, what is the leading cause of Amazon destruction? Animal agriculture, yep, go for it. That's again, Team Banana, to clean up. Or livestock, yeah, it's a mix between clearing rainforest to grow crops to then feed animals, and just clearing rainforest to just raise pasture, just do pasture, and that's about, depending on, I think the World Bank was 70%, some like BNP says it's more like 80% of all Amazon destruction is from that. People are like, oh, it's logging. No, they just do the logging so that they can clear it out for animal agriculture. So, all right, next step. You want it? What do you want to get? No one's posing veggies for labs yet. Oh, you can't see. Oh, sorry. Yeah. Yeah. Veggie celebrity going on. Yeah, and okay, quick recap right now, because you probably can't read it at all. So, Team Banana has $1,400, Team Onion has $300, and Team Watermelon has $900 right now. So, yeah, way to go, guys. Okay, so feel free to go to the next one. Or you already chose to get stuff from me. All right, that's it for this. Diva started a vegan food delivery service that will soon implement artificial intelligence. It is Beyonce. Oh my gosh. She's cleaning up one. Yeah, you're cleaning up so hard right now. Yeah. Yeah, Beyonce, apparently she's not fully vegan. She's not vegan, but loves to do the vegan business. And that's, I think that's always a good sign that, like, people are like, I want to make money. I know I can make money off this, so I can do this. Like, all these giant plant-based or giant meat companies like Tyson and Dustin and plant-based meat, it's kind of messed up that it's like, you're vegan and then you're paying these large animal agriculture companies. But then it also shows that you can make a ton of money on it, and it's billions and billions of dollars that you make. So they're doing it. So that's a good sign. Okay. See you next one. Veggie Celebs 200. All right. Once a lifeguard in red, the celebrity can now be found submitting formal appeals to protect sea creatures. He's embarrassed about you. Like, I know too much. I'm not even going to. Okay. Neil Anderson is correct. Yep. Baywatch got an animal activist. So that is once again Team Banana, which now it's at $1,700. And by the way, the winner of this is going to get a shirt for the Veg Fest, and then I will drop them out on my channel. So that'll be fun. Okay. Guess again. I mean, it's just the same. Yeah, go for it. Vegan mad scientist for $500 clearing out the most valuable one. Okay. The secret ingredient of the Impossible Burger is that makes it bleed. Team Iron is correct, particularly like hemoglobin, which is heme iron from soy. I believe it's soybeans. Because soybeans, going back to nitrogen fixation, they fix nitrogen from the air and create that protein. And they do it by actually having a symbiotic relationship with these bacteria in the root nodule. So they get infected by this bacteria, it's creating an anaerobic environment, and then they start using the energy from the plant to fix nitrogen out of the air, which is a super energy intense process, and that creates heme iron. And so heme iron is like a metallic taste of meat, and so you can mimic it. So you can bite, people bite into the Impossible Burger, and they get that metallic taste that they've never had in the veggie burger before, And if you don't tell them it's meat, there have been many times that they thought it was actually meat. It's crazy, because it's not. And there's some controversies, because they were forced, allegedly forced to test on animals, and so it's like, vegans are like, screw you, impossible burger, but, you know, it is what it is. Okay. Feel free to test them. Or, well, that was too bad, I guess. You can just test banana every time at this point. I'm sorry, dude. Sorry, I didn't mean to be mean to you, guys. Okay, well, feel free to go. Vegas celebrity $500. Peter Dean, this Twitter-happy superstar musician, the veganist vegan who has a vegan. Who is first? Are you guys watching? Yeah, you. Nope. Are you? Nope. Yeah. Yeah. I was going to give you the wrecking ball hint, but you got it first. All right. My style is once again in the banana. And here's the thing. A lot of times people will be winning this by a lot, but then at the end we're going to do the final round, which is a wager. And if they get the wager wrong and somebody else, that's not nice. Some people keep up from behind. So don't feel like you're losing if you're losing, and don't get too comfortable in that lead. Okay. All right, so that's the next one. What's the next one? Environment for $300. According to a government paper by Senator Tom Harkin, livestock in the U.S. produces 39 billion humans worth of blank. Where's this blank? I give you, there's no hint I can give you about getting this right. Yep. Poop is the answer. Now you know why there's no hint. I guess I could do it. Maybe figure one out. But yeah, that's insane. That is 5.5 of the T-minus. Yeah, you can, did you add it already? You can subtract. Yeah, just press that button. Yeah, subtract. Ooh. Anyway, so while that's happening, yeah, okay, so they did a government paper and they were like, how much poop is being created in the U.S. from all, you know, agriculture? And so Senator Tom Harkin and his people put it together, and it's 39 billion people, which is 5.5 times the population of Earth, just from poop, just from livestock, just from the U.S. Although most of it going down into the Gulf of Mexico, which is already in the desert. But that's insane. $300, so you have a 700 onion, and now we're moving on, and that's, yep. Go for it. Where do you get your protein for $400? Fred is more like, hey, popularized the what myth about protein. Yeah? Read the book, Diet for a Small Planet. You do it. What's the myth about protein? Just forget about Francis. What's the myth about protein? That is a myth, but. Yeah. Yeah, I talked about it. It's myth number 4 in my last video. You can do it. Okay, so I'm gonna give you a hint really quickly. People might want to put rice and beans together to create a blank. Complete protein, if you press the button first, yeah, gotta keep your hand on that buzzer. Okay. Complete protein, do you team a watermelon? Or combining proteins, yes. Good job, guys, you did it, yeah. So she came back in a revised version and was like, you know, I was actually wrong. She was like, you have to be mixing all these plant-based proteins. This was the 70s, by the way. You got to put rice and beans together so you have a complete amino acid profile or an even one. And it just turns out that it's basically complete nonsense. It's super easy to get all of your amino acids from eating plants unless you're literally drinking orange juice like I talked about. You're going to do it really easily. Okay, so let's move on. What do you want to choose next? Team watermelon. Where do you get your protein, $200? Name the animal with the lowest breast milk protein on planet Earth. Human! Yes, team onion. We get all the money. So, yeah, think about that. So, we have the lowest protein of any animal on Earth, obviously mammal. And that is because we have the longest time to maturity. So, obviously, protein is for growth. The faster you grow, if you're a rat that grows really fast, your protein content of your milk is going to be super high, so you need more protein. But for us, first of all, we're already grown, we're not growing. And second of all, we grow to maturity super slowly. And so we don't really need as much protein as this is like a nice mind thing to kind of think about. Because if you think we need so much protein, everyone's eating 3 times as much protein as they need to eat. And so we're just delusional as a species. Right now, well, I will say it's great to be here. I just went to San Francisco and I was riding a bike that had the same shop bikes. You can just get on the app, jump on an electric bike, and it's sweet. And I just rode around some vegan, you know, all these vegan places to vegan places. And has anybody seen the sea lions down there? so funny. It is so funny. They just remind me of politics nowadays. They're just like constantly pushing each other off these little blocks. Anyway, you gotta go. It's the perfect reflection. All right, so who's got the next one?
Take one again.
Ready to get your protein for 500. We've got a high roller here. The only male U.S. weightlifter to qualify for the Rio Olympics instead of U.S. weightlifter. Who is it? There's no way. There's no amount of facts that I can give you. If you can remember the last name, first name is Kendrick, last name Blake. Kendrick Blake. That's like $500 if it's hard. Okay, well, is anybody from the audience know? Kendrick Ferris is the answer, yes. Kendrick Ferris. This one I love so much because it just shatters everything you could possibly think about protein, protein and vegans. Vegans are super weak and all that jazz, but this guy came and just destroyed. He set a record for the U.S. and he's a vegan. And so you can't be like, vegans are weak, they can't get strong. This guy was the strongest in the U.S. in that particular category at that time. And he's still, I'm pretty sure that record still exists. So what are you going to say about protein? Anyway, I'll never get over protein being annoying. Okay. Next up, nobody. How about T-Money? Animals for $300, and the question is, but farm animals from this species can recognize themselves in the mirror. Farm animals. I hope no one's farming. Sorry, I didn't know how to do it. Piggies, yeah. You hit it in spirit. you did? Oh, I guess you like that. Okay, yeah. Piggies. And that goes to Team Banana, yes, and extra points if you say stuff for a domesticus. that was great. Anyway, so that was bananas. Obviously, that's not necessarily a defining factor of whether or not you kill an animal to eat the animal, but just the idea that a pig is so intelligent that they can look in front of the mirror and know exactly that is insane. And there's a decent amount. There's other animals like magpies are probably the smallest one, which is crazy that they can recognize themselves in the mirror. But other than that, dolphins, primates, and so forth. So, go for the next one. We're getting pretty sparse on the board here. Veggie celeb for $300. Name this Hollywood actor who is also the singer who 30 Seconds to Mars. Jared Leto is the answer, yes. Jared Leto, yep. People are always like, they see him. Apparently, he's like 40 something or 50. He's like getting older. How old is he? He's getting older. He's like, oh, yeah. Anyway, so he was so young, which is crazy. And he's been vegan for a while. And you'll see interviews with him, and he'll be like, he'll literally just straight up say, like, Jerry is disgusting plus, and I can't believe, like, I would just never drink it. It's just so funny to see that, because it's like, Jared Leto, he's in all these movies and stuff, and you just, I don't know, he's like A-list celebrity, so you can't be like, you're a crazy vegan, and everyone's just like, okay, yeah. Okay, anyway, let's move on. Veggie celeb for 400, the last veggie celeb of the day. And name the voice of Earthlings. The voice of the documentary Earthlings. So, can I give a bit of a hint? No? No one knows? No one knows? You know, but do you know? Nope. Okay, let's go back to 2000s. Here's the movie Gladiator. He plays Caesar in Gladiator. Hit the button.
Joaquin, you can do it.
Yeah, rising from the ashes, what animal, what mythical creature rose from the ashes? Do you get it? How do you guys want to do this? Do you want to give it to the team? Okay, so that was a really ambiguous situation. He got the first half right. Split it? I'll give you a hint. Okay, so it's $3,300 to $900. So let's get the game even. Give it to Onion. Team Onion, yes, yes. We'll get it. All right, Team Onion gets it. Okay, great. So, and then I'll let Team Watermelon get the next one, just to keep that at least going. So, Team Watermelon. Oh, are you getting it? I'm just getting even amount. Yeah, perfect. Well, this is a question for everybody. According to the World Watch Institute, livestock is responsible for X percent of human greenhouse gas emissions. I could even imagine the highest estimate that there is. It's like 13%. Mathematically, it might not work that way. But I appreciate your effort. What percent of all emissions in the world are from life science. You take the button. Lower than that. Okay, so okay, the lower, the more widely accepted, this is way up there. The more widely accepted ones are the FAO's 14.5% and then the FAO's 18%. And so those are way lower. So I'll give you each of you gets 1 more percentage guess. No, the lower. 38, higher than 38. 42. Okay, we're supposed to get this one. It's 51%. And yeah, that's the Worldwide Institute. Yeah, and the way they came to that number, they decided to look at the larger systems of how much, you know, for example, when we're cutting down trees, how much cutting down trees, like the Amazon rainforest, how much are you losing in terms of carbon sequestration potential? And then they also used a shorter time period. So, for example, methane is super powerful at a 20-year span, but most of these other studies are looking at a 100-year span. So nothing goes up in the atmosphere and it comes down, but it's a really powerful one that's up there. And you care about what's happening to the ice cap right now. And so they were like, we're going to do 20 years. And so that cranked it all the way up to 51% of all emissions. So let's keep it going. Nobody got that one. So team, I mean, what do you want next? Environment for $400 for our last 5 seconds. There are now over 500 of these compromised areas of the ocean. Andy. What are dead zones? That is correct. Dead zones. Dead on. Yep. And I will say, they do not necessarily exist all year. So when it gets warmer, reflecting a bunch of nitrate fertilizer into the ocean, and then you got the sun in the summer, and then it just blooms like crazy. And so 500, you know, at various points in the year. And so it's not all of them. Just to clarify. All right, so what do you want next? Animals for $400. The question is, the wild ancestor of the modern chicken. What is the wild ancestor of the modern chicken? Yeah? What is the pterodactyl? Correct, you won everything. That was the secret answer. You get $1 million. See you guys. That's what you think. I can throw out some hints. Now we throw out some hints on this one. So, the first word is one of the words in a country down, going south of Asia. Papua New Blank. That is correctly. So that, okay, sorry. That is the first. Guinea hen is the correct answer. That is one of the correct answers. Watermelon gets all the money for that one. Team Watermelon. Yes, guinea hen. Or guinea fowl, technically. The guinea hen is the female. Okay, I have it right there. It's one of the correct answers. So good job. That one's a hard one to get. You did it. You did it. You pulled through. So, guess for this one? Yeah. Guess for 400, and don't click on yet. Quick recap. So, $3,300 for banana, $1,300 for onion, and $2,300 for watermelon. So, easing out a little bit. Yeah, round of applause for our contestants for putting yourselves up here. Anytime you're on the spot, you just start shouting weird things, and so you guys are doing so good. $1,500, all the money. Okay, so it was $400. Okay. Yep, plants for $400 is new companies are making leather alternatives with the fibers of this plant. The fibers of this plant. Did you hear it? Yeah, just check. Just go for it. Just sure. Oh, my God. That might be. Let's get a backup guess. Okay, you're going to say bamboo, mushroom, plant, pineapple. Okay, so we got back-to-back-to-back. So show me, can I do this? So, see the answer, I guess. Say, see the answer. Because it is that long. There's pineapple, banana leaf, grape, apple, teak leaves. Bamboo, you know, bamboo isn't on there, but I would venture to say that there are so many leather alternatives. Although, nothing's kind of like a name. Do we want to give it to... We got pineapple over there is correct. Bamboo is not technically an answer. What do you guys think? Watermelon? Okay, they want to get the watermelon because there's probably somebody making some leather bamboo out of the basement. And so, sure, why not? Okay, so let's have you guess the next one, or choose the next one. So you're going to have to add $400 to watermelon, so $2,700. And then, the answer could be whatever you want. We're getting... Where do you get your protein for $100? Germany's strongest man in 2011, this is even strong man, carried 1,300 pounds, 30 feet. In other words, he's really strong, and he's German. He's originally from, like, No one knows? Okay, let's just try to give a hint in case you might not get it. His first name is the same as a holiday, which people drink a lot, and there's a lot of green. I'm hearing this person. Patrick is his first name, so Patrick's like, Patrick, all right, I think we're gonna. Okay, audience, for 3, 2, 1, Patrick. Patrick Baboumian. So we're gonna skip that one. Nobody gets that money. Patrick, come on, get out there more. No, he's everywhere. He's good. And I just saw like a video of him. Yeah, he does this yoke thing where he has this giant metal sort of U thing over him, and he's got, you can put weight on it, and he just has like 4 people standing on it, and he's just going like this, and just like. As wide as he is tall as a muscle. And so, he's great. Follow him on Instagram. Okay. So, let's just have onion juice. Thanks for 100. Been looking for an excuse to be vegan. One could say that plants feel this.
What do you think? You hit it first?
Okay, yeah, onion gets the $100. Yeah, plants. It's a common argument that plants feel pain in the moment you start talking about animals. Some people will say that. That's their go-to, and I have a whole video on it, so you should watch it. And definitely, yeah. In case you don't know, in case you're just here, I'm Mike the Vegan. I have a YouTube channel in case you can later. And yes, thank you very much. And it's all about science, in the name of science. Okay. So last question. Just go for it. Just do it. This human practice is the leading threat to quails. Did somebody get it when I wasn't looking? Okay. Okay, you said fishing. Yeah, that's good. Team Watermelon gets it. Bypassed from fishing. So fishing, human fishing, which is crazy. Because you would think whaling. People are going out there and trying to kill whales, which is sort of, you know, a type of fishing, although it's not fish. We're, you know, they're mammals. But the idea is that it's pretty crazy. So we have some final round action right here. Each of you has a piece of paper on your desk. One of you is missing a pen. So if anybody in the audience wants to remove that, go for it. Or you can share it. And so, go for it. Yeah, so we're going to do a wager, which means this is the last big question. Look how nice these people are. The last big question is the final question of it, and you're going to wager. I want to wager this much money, and if you win it, you get that money. If you get the right answer on that paper, if you get the wrong answer, you lose that money. So, simple example, if I was Team Onion, and I really wanted to beat Banana, or that's mathematically impossible, sorry. If I was Team Watermelon, and there was I'm the worst host ever. 30, okay, so Team Watermelon, well, actually that's not true, because Team Banana could lose money. But let's say Team Watermelon wants to wager $200, because they're $100 short of the other team. If they get it right, they get the $200. If they get the question wrong, they lose the $200. So they will get them with $3,000. Now you're confused. But it's good, because, yeah, you gotta write. So write down the name of your team, and then when we get to the question, you can write down the answer. Okay. So you have to wager before you know the question. So bet it all. Just bet it all away. I'm gonna start a gambling addiction in all of these reasons. Bad. All right, so you want, okay, let's help him out a little bit. So, yeah, you only need to wager 100, so we got to wager him? Wait, did we get to wager him? Oh, sorry, they choose what amount they have. Fun fact, fun thing before you enter in, I'm going to ramble, but allegedly, according to the research, after about 7 years, you replace every cell in your body, pretty much. And so, I've been vegan for 7 years as of recently. So, that means somehow I was able to build my whole body without animal protein. And so, what does that tell you? Okay. Enter the final wages. Okay, so, these are, do you want to do secretly or do you not care? I don't think we can. Eagerly? Okay, so go and hand them up. Go and hand them up to a master working in the back. Doing all the magic. All right, yeah. So that's cool. So it means every, you know, my corneas and whatever are made from plants. And all the phones, like, have all calcium is from plants in my bones. And so anybody who's been vegan for several more years should technically be dead, according to Gang's theory. And through the way it is, yes. And then we're going to do the final question. Yep. So that's cool. So, yeah, let's just hang out a little bit. Let's do it. Oh, right, you did it. That's nice. All right, play now. Okay, the final question is back over, back on. Okay, the final question is, this country has recently established the target of reducing their meat consumption by 50%. Okay, let's give you some hints. Yeah?
China is the answer. After randomly shouting out every country in the world, we have received the answer.
Okay, so they just did it, yeah. And, okay, great. So I just messed the whole thing up, but that's okay. How much did you win? 200, yeah. Okay, so you win.
Yeah, team, the winner is Team Watermelon. Everybody give Team Watermelon a round of applause.
And yeah, I got so flubbed. That was supposed to be a secret. They were supposed to write down the answer. But it's okay. You know, it was great. Rules don't matter. We've been over this. All right, so that is it for the Jeopardy game. Thank you so much for coming. I appreciate it. Working through all of those little technical details and all that. And final round of applause for these people who just vulnerably put their whole soul out there and shouted all those answers. So, and the winners get 2 Veg Fest shirts and a shout out on my channel. So, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. If anybody wants to come talk to me, I'm going to be doing some quick interview stuff. And after that, feel free to come up. I'd love to talk to anybody. So, yeah, thank you so much for coming out. Bye.